Hello everyone, it's Ed with Creative Solutions. I'd like to do a video this evening that's long overdue. First of all, I would like to send a great big shout out to Captain Jeff over at CJS Knives. I was in a predicament a couple weeks back where I designed some knives and my handle material didn't work out for me. So I contacted Jeff and he was kind enough to send me a few items over. Here shortly I'm going to show you some stills of what he sent, the raw material, and then I'll actually show you some of the items I was able to make with the materials that he sent over. So let me readjust my kind of a dual purpose video, I guess. I have a few items that are available. It's going to be a first come first serve type of deal. I do show these items on other forums, so I have other venues, and it's basically going to be a first come first serve type of deal. First of all, I'd like to show you one of the items that I made with some material Jeff sent over. And it's this here. Bushcraft style knife. The scales are black palm with yellow liners. The pins are nickel silver, and I have a stainless lanyard tube, quarter inch stainless lanyard tube. I believe, get you a tape so we can take a look at the overall length here. The overall length of the knife, 7.5 inches. We're looking at approximately a 3.5 inch blade from the ricasso area, so from the end of the handle to the tip, it's 3.5 inches. We have a handle that is approximately 3¾ inches. This is a beautiful, beautiful knife. Came out really, really nice. It has a, I would call a high polish. Of course, some might say it's, if I could do this, it's mirror. But, you know, if you look close, I mean, there's still some minor scratches and things like that in it. But this is one of the first items I have available. The sheath I'm not going to make. I'm going to speak to the person who contacts me first. There's a couple of options for sheaths. One's going to be a full-blown bushcraft style, which I have in my other videos. And a second option would be a sheath, kind of like a Ray Mears type of fold-over sheath. It's a little simpler design, still very high quality. It just really depends on an individual's likes or dislikes. And of course the cost difference between the two. This is actually made out of 1095, and this is going to be the first one that's available. The second one that's available is this Kiridashi. And again, this is some of the material that Captain Jeff sent over to me. This is bamboo, and I opted to put bamboo on this Kiridashi for two reasons. One, kind of that oriental thing. Two, it gives you a little more purchase on the knife with a little broader handle and little custom design. Instead of a round hole, I went and put a triangular hole and kind of matched the scales. And again, we have what I call just a high polish. Some would say mirror again, but just a high polish. Outstanding knife. Comes to an extreme point and very, very sharp. This one has no liners. Again, I do have the nickel silver pins. And with this, I may make a small kydex sheath or a small leather sheath. I haven't built any of the sheaths for these yet. I was really waiting to talk to the individuals to see what they were more interested in, what their preference was. Let's take a look at this. I keep laying this down on the hide and they kind of disappear. So overall length for this is 5.5 inches, and the width is approximately just a little over an inch at its widest point. But very beautiful. And I do still have to etch my logo onto all the knives, which I will do. I'm going to do that on video as well, because it's something I've been asked to show. And I recently, two months ago, changed the way I do things. So I'd like to show that. Okay, second of all, now we have another Kiradashi with a little different. This one has no pins in it. This is made out of solid oak hardwood flooring. Overall dimensions are pretty much the same as the other. Again, razor sharp. I put handles on these, like I said, just to change it up a little bit. Do something a little bit different than what everybody else is doing out there. And hopefully, you know, these are some things that you, the viewers, like and are interested in. Again, another high polish. Extremely sharp. Not going to do any type of cut test or anything like this, you know. Either it's sharp or it's not. So, the more I say it is, the more, you know, some people believe, disbelieve. And one of the final items that I made, oh, and by the way, this one is made out of 01 tool steel as well. Okay, next up, it's just a design, no particular, I guess a miniature chef's knife, I would call it, with some deer antler scales, high polish. All these, like I say, do have a minor scratches and things like that. They're not completely mirror finished. I mean, you could see yourself, you could probably see around the room, stuff like that, but it's not what I consider mirror. Again, we have the nickel silver pins, the dyed antler, and buffed out. These were also stabilized with wood hardener, so there's no way that these are going to shrink unless, you know, you really put it through some extremes. And this one here is made out of 1095 tool steel, or 1095, I'm sorry, not tool steel. These two are tool steel here, and this one is tool steel here. So if anybody's interested, you know, please feel free to PM me. Ask a few more questions if you like, but I also have a couple more items. One is a dyed deer antler tine with a 3/8 inch ferrule. Well, I believe it's 3/8 inch, maybe it's a quarter. Let me take a look. 3/8 inch ferrule rod by 3 inches. That's exactly what it is. And have this one available. I also have a few more tines that are unfinished, and you can see these are chamfered. Everything's done. This is buffed, so they all look pretty nice. It's pretty a heavy duty ferrocerium rod there. All top quality. A couple more antler tines that are dyed. If you have a preference in ferrocerium rod, or you want to see a magnesium rod in one, or just the tine itself, you know, shoot me a PM if you're interested. Just a few items I have that are kind of ready to go. This is kind of a unique item. It's a deer antler fork, and on one side we have a whistle, the other side we have a 1/4 inch by 3 inch ferrocerium rod, and the whistle's incorporated. So as you can see, that works out very, very well. Very well. Kind of different, kind of unique. Figured I would try to put out something different there. Now off of the same, fork where I cut the tine off, I made just a small whistle. This one's not near as loud. Kind of high pitched. A little different to blow also. But you only can put in, you know, just so big of a bore hole in there before you would actually cut through the tine. So on the little one, I came closer to the camera so you could kind of hear this. So that's the sound of the little one here. What we have here are two elk antler tips, and they're both dyed. This one actually has a lanyard, brass lanyard tube, 1/4 inch inserted. Ends are chamfered, and this has a carbide striker, about 1/2 inch exposed by 1/2 inch approximately wide. Yep, right on. And this thing throws sparks like you would not believe. This is one of the best strikers I've ever made, ever. It's big enough you can hold this thing and not worry about it slipping or you not being able to grasp it to get the force behind it. You're not going to bust this thing out of here either. This is really heavy duty, very nice. This is another antler, elk antler tip. What I did with this, I opted to do with this, since it wasn't as big and just a little bit smaller, I went ahead and put in a carbon steel hacksaw blade. And this side still has the teeth to help with removing the black on your ferrocerium rod. And then this was been re-90'd, so you got a good edge here. The hole's been left in, and then what I did is I also created this round end. And what the round end does, it fits your ferrocerium rod really nice, and it allows you to shoot your spark out really well. So, then I've rounded off the edges so there's nothing that's going to catch or hurt you or cut you. The hacksaw end will be a little irritating if it rubs against you for quite a while, but I don't think it's anything too bad. So I have that. And then last thing I want to show you guys are these scales here. I have three sets of scales. This is buffalo bone. These two sets are deer bone. And this is more material that Jeff had sent me in its raw form. And then I was able to shape it down into some scales that will be used on future projects. On the buffalo bone, I went ahead and already set on some black liners, and they're pretty much evened out, ready to go. What I'm going to have to do is to use these, I'm kind of going to have to design the knife handle around the knife. That's one of the things I learned, and what I want to do is do a video to show people who haven't used bone how to measure it in preparation for a particular knife that they're going to do. This way they have a good idea if the material they have on hand is going to work or not, or if they're going to have to source something else. And these two sets here are deer antler leg bone. Oh, I'm sorry. Deer antler leg bone. Yeah, right. leg bone on both of them. And as you can see, they're both different thicknesses, different widths. And I don't know how well you're going to see this, but they come down to a pretty fine taper. So what you're going to have to do is measure the usable thickness, and that's going to determine the width of your blade. But again, I'll do a video showing that, and hopefully it'll help somebody out. But these are some of the things I have to offer at this time. I have a bunch of other things in the works. I just haven't really had time to do a lot of videos. They just take so much time for me. I use cheap Coolpix, so you can see the quality really isn't there. But, you know, we'll upgrade when we can. Kind of give you a couple different looks here. So if anybody's interested, please feel free to PM me, and I'll respond, and we'll discuss price and sheath options. That's basically why I can't give you out a price. I really don't know what each individual is looking for, and I really want to make it something that would suit your needs, not my needs. So again, this was Ed with Creative Solutions.
Well, I just heard the news today. It seems my life is gonna change. I close my eyes, begin to pray. Then tears of joy stream down my face. By my side, we're standing on.